moved to the Grammar within a mile of here when I was 2 years old from Columbus, Indiana. And I've been extremely blessed that I have stayed in this locale all my life and all my business life. There's about 45 houses left in Grammar. We're the primary business here, but it worked out very well for us to be positioned here with the trucking company. In 68, I graduated from Purdue, came home to farm, but we bought the grain elevator at that same year, and so we incorporated the grain operation with farming. In 72, I got rid of the farming operation. We kept the Graham and started basically in the trucking business. But in 86, our life kind of changed that we bought this Ohio fleet out of Lima, Ohio, which added about 25 units to our fleet. So we doubled in size within a year. The next year we bought U.S. Steel's fleet, another 25 units. In 1988, we bought the Agrico fleet, which was 108 trailers. I guess about 1998, we become very involved in the clean air programs of the power plants of anhydrous ammonia going in for clean air. And that introduced us to more to the industrial side. We opened another door and another path. And since basically about 2008 to the present time, we've almost doubled the size of our company. I'm very honored. I just finished serving a term as chairman of the American Trucking Association last year, which represented about 37,000 trucking companies through all 50 states in the U.S. And it was very, very easy for me to blow on the horn of both Mississippi Trailers and for Blackmer from a standpoint of quality, from a standpoint of durability, and reliability, and the ability to work with the personnel that you were buying the stuff from. I was somewhat surprised with the benefits of the breast cancer trailer that we now have. Scott and Joey from Mississippi Tank had come up with the idea. And Scott came to me one day and he said, "What do you think about doing a breast cancer trailer?" And my first comment was, "Who in the world would ever pull a pink trailer in that was a macho truck driver?" And I have been proven wrong about that 100 times over.
You know, I think everybody is either directly involved with a family member or knows somebody that's had breast cancer, dealt with breast cancer. So it was a very good fit for us because, you know, everybody at my plant in Hattiesburg got excited. Everybody at Vincent's got excited. I know all the Grammar people got excited. I know the drivers were probably fighting to get this trailer
right,
because they're so proud of the cause, and it meant a lot to everybody.
As a motivational tool for Grammar Industries, it is priceless.
And the response from the industry has just been overwhelming. It really has been.
The one thing with the Blackmer compressed gas pumps that we use in our fleet here at Grammar Industries, we have approximately 145 of them, is the serviceability and rebuild ability of their product. With Grammar Industries, like I said, we operate 145 of these transports doing various different kinds of compressed gases. Blackmer is our pump of choice for the serviceability throughout the United States, the parts availability throughout the United States. We work very close with engineering at Blackmer. Engineering ships us a care package. We put it into service. After it's been through its life cycle and ship it all back to engineering to help develop better seals, better bearings, better vanes, and the end result is a better pump for the customer. That's why we have teamed up for years with Blackmer.
Well, I think Grammar Industries and Blackmer go together. They're both interested in being successful. They're both interested in doing the right thing. Very caring about the kind of application that we have and what Grammar Industries' needs are.